السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus, the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri Rahmatullahi Alayh.
Lesson number 871. Carrying on with the incident of Mi'raj, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as he was boarded the Buraq, the flight stopped once again. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam performed two rakats of salah. Jibreel alayhi salam asked, "Do you know which place is this?" The Nabi of Allah said, "I don't know." So Jibreel alayhi salam said, "This is a place of Madian. This is where Shu'aib alayhi salam's house was." Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam boarded the flight of the Buraq and carried on. Again Jibreel alayhi salam stopped and they read two rakats of salah. Jibreel alayhi salam asked, "Do you know which place is this?" The Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "I don't know." Jibreel alayhi salam thereafter responded and said, "This is a place called Baytul Laham. This is Bethlehem, where Isa alayhi salam was born." This narration is made mention by Ibn Abi Hatib Bayhaqi Bazzar from the narrator Hazrat Shaddad ibn Aus radiallahu ta'ala an. The Buraq thereafter carried on the journey, and there was an old lady that was summoning the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was told by Jibreel alayhi salam not to respond and to carry on. Thereafter they met an old man, and he also was trying to get the attention of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But Jibreel alayhi salam told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to carry on. Thereafter, they saw a group of people, and they made salam to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said, "Assalamu alayka ya awwal, assalamu alayka ya akhir, assalamu alayka ya hashir." So Jibreel alayhi salam told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to give an answer to these people. So as they went forward, they asked, "O Jibreel, who are those people?" So Jibreel alayhi salam answered, "The old lady, this is what we know as this world. The amount of time left in her age, there is the amount of time that is left for this world to come to an end. And she was trying to entice you towards this world. The old man that you met, that was the devil himself, and he was trying to get your attention. And the group of people that you met was Ibrahim alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam, and they were there and they were greeting you." This hadith is made mention of by Ibn Jarir Bayhaqi on the authority of Hazrat Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Thereafter, Sahih Muslim makes mention of the narration. Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu is the narrator. He said, "When Jibreel alayhi salam took me on the night of Mi'raj, thereafter I passed the grave of Musa alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam was standing in his grave, and Musa alayhi salam was reading Salah." Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma says that on the night of Mi'raj, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seen Musa alayhi salam, he seen Dajjal, he seen the one that was responsible for hellfire, the person that is overseeing it, his name is Malik. This hadith is made mention both in Sahih Muslim as well as Sahih Bukhari under the authority of Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. The narration also states, this narration is made mention in Ahmad in Abu Dawud, also under the authority of Anas radiallahu anhu, that the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed by people who had copper nails, and they were scratching their faces and they were scratching their chest. So thereafter the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked, "What were those people doing?" He said, "These were the people that used to eat the flesh of their brother," meaning they used to backbite, they used to degrade, they used to look down upon the fellow Muslims, and hence they are being punished for this year. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala save us. Thereafter, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam seen an individual who was swimming, and he was gobbling pebbles. He was gobbling stones. So Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, what did this person do? He said, this person here, he was used to partake of sood, of interest. And there is a punishment for this. The narrator of this hadith is Samura ibn Junub radiallahu ta'ala an. Then the Nabi of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed by a group of people. They had planted a seed. Immediately the seed had grown. They had partaken from the fruit. And thereafter it went back to normal. But immediately they plant another seed, and immediately it grows. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam asked that, what are these people? And Jibreel alayhi salam said that these people were those that strived in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For every good deed that they done, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them 700 good rewards in reward. And whatever they will do, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant them a good replacement for the sacrifices they had done. Let us read durood on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad bi'adad kulli dharra mi'ata alf marra. Ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.